This is 7 Mile. Coming from the top of Swamp Creek. This is a fairly decent trail. It's a lot more fun with snow on it than it is in the summer. The creek crossings are interesting as they freeze over and it gets deeper and deeper and creates shelves. That's farther down. Well past the abandoned mine. Today we are in my new 2017 Polaris RZR S 1000. Still in the break-in mode. I got a few hours to go before my first oil change. And as you can see, only ATVs have been able to make it up to the top of 7 Mile so far. The Jeeps have to turn around right before the mine, at least up until this weekend. They might be able to get all the way through. There's a fallen tree towards the bottom that I'm not sure if there's enough clearance for Jeeps to get through. But anyway, I'm really, really liking this new machine. Tons of power. Oh my God, does this thing have tons of power. I bet you're not even one third into the throttle and you're already past my old RZR 800. Easily. We've had a lot of warm weather lately, so a lot of this has been melting. Last weekend, I was able to make it about two-thirds of the way up, maybe. And this weekend I made it all the way to the top. Swamp Creek is still pretty packed. 171B, I tried going down it. Looked like I was the very first person all season, really, to even attempt to do 171B. And it got too deep. I had to floor it out of there backwards. Get it out. Yeah, this is where I made it last weekend. I made it to here. And so the rest of the way it was pretty deep. So it's melted quite a bit. Not sure about the winter challenge, which is coming up. I'm by myself today. It's not like I would attempt to winter challenge by myself anyway. That'd be kind of sketchy. Not that it wouldn't be bad. It just sucked to have to get stuck, you know, halfway up and have to winch all the way to the top and then try to make it back down. I'll have a separate video explaining the different things I've done since I've got this. There's the abandoned mine. I believe that's called Manhattan Mine. I haven't found the official name of that mine. But essentially this area was called Manhattan. Here's the start of the Winter Challenge. Well, not necessarily the start, but this is the access road to get to the Winter Challenge. It doesn't look too bad, but it won't be worth going up there if I'm not going to do it anyway. But anyway, that's the access road to get to Winter Challenge. Winter Challenge is only open in the winter. And of course, I have a separate video with the RZR S making it to the top. I'm not exactly sure why they call it a challenge. It's more of a challenge to get there than it is to actually do it. But in the RZR, with the deep snow, pretty much just full throttle the whole way up. With the deep snow and the steepness, butch this thing, man, full throttle up that. It would be pretty crazy. So maybe next weekend I can bring up Dubs, hopefully. He said he was sick, he couldn't go today. But that's kind of the claim to fame of 7 Mile, is these creek crossings. As the water builds up, it creates a good sized shelf. And if you don't have a vehicle with good ground clearance, it can be kind of a challenge. Especially like an older four-wheel drive ATV, or if you're like Dubs and you're trying this in a quad, I'm trying to get him to get a four-wheel drive, maybe someday. But I have to give him credit for attempting a lot of these trails in a quad. You just don't see any quads out here, so he's unique in that way. I don't know if that's unique in a good way or a bad way, but that's unique. But 7 Mile is about 40 minutes up the Poudre Canyon from Ted's place. Ted's place is the gas station of Highway 14 and 287. So, maybe just under an hour or so from Fort Collins to the trailhead of 7 Mile. So not too far. And what you can do is, you can come up, it's on the same road as the west end of Kelly Flats trailhead. So you can come up, you know, being an ATV or UTV side by side, you technically can't drive on County Road 69, which is also called Manhattan Road. You're not supposed to, but anyway, you can come up at the trailhead of 7 Mile. You can do 7 Mile in Swamp Creek, come back down, load up, go about maybe a mile and a half up the road to the west end of the Kelly Flats trailhead, and then you can do Kelly Flats. So you get basically three trails in one day. I've done that a couple times. What kind of sucks about that situation though is we like to get here super early, and as you can see, there's nobody here. Now if I was coming down this trail at noon, it'd be packed. You'd have ATVs, dirt bikes, Jeeps. It's really freaking annoying. So, you get here really, really early, but you get here early enough to do, like, say, 7 Mile in Swamp Creek, and by the time you get to Kelly Flats, then you're gonna start getting into traffic and crowded trails. So we gotta keep that in mind. But I really like to get in early, you know, the butt crack of dawn, hit the trails, screw around and get out before pretty much the majority of people show up. I mean, it's not even 8:30 and I'm basically done. But that's what it is. That's kind of how I prefer it. Get in, get out before the people show up. Because it really is annoying having to deal with other people on the trails. But this should be a good year. I'm hoping to head down south a lot more. My bucket list, my number one bucket list is the Crystal Mill Mine, which is over by Marble and Carbondale. I think it was the other major town there. But basically it's by Marble, Colorado. And It's one of the most photographed areas in Colorado. But that's my bucket list thing. I don't know if I want to go ahead and attempt to go twice. One time in the summer, and then another in the fall. Because the pictures people get in the fall are fantastic. But it's apparently not as crowded in the summer because it's not as photographic in the summer. So we'll see about that, but that's my number one thing. Last year, my number one bucket list was Rollins Pass, which I'll of course go there again. It's so beautiful up there. Also down south would be like the Alpine Loop and Black Canyon of the Gunnison. I hope to go to Stillwater Pass over by Grand Lake and Granby. Ridden dirt bikes there a lot, but I haven't been there in an ATV or a side-by-side ever. And the last time I was there on a dirt bike was probably, about 2002, 2003. It's been a while. Really pretty area. Should be a lot of fun on a side-by-side. And then there's another trail kind of north of Red Feather. Might have to camp out for that one because the trail goes all the way up into Wyoming, so that's kind of neat. You got a border crossing. I'm not sure if it's marked. That'd be kind of cool if there's a little, like a sign saying, hey, now you're in Wyoming. I don't remember the name of it right offhand, but it's just north of Chicken Road and Creemore Lakes. But you see, you get these shelves. And if you don't have adequate ground clearance, they kind of screw it a little bit. Not a very good trail for a dirt bike right now. But in the winter time, you basically, in this area, you have Sevenmile and you have Swamp Creek that are open. The Forest Service closes pretty much everything else. And then towards the other area, like Masonville, apparently Greer and Ballard Road are open. I haven't been there at all once this year. I wonder what's up with that. But maybe I'll check it out next weekend. They never did close that one, according to the website. But anyway, that's kind of the only areas we got to play around here with an ATV. I have a trip coming up to Jackson Hole, Wyoming in March. Not sure I'm bringing the RZR to there. Actually, I'm pretty sure I'm not. But I'll definitely research the situation. I know there's a lot of off-road trails right by Jacksonville. Jackson Hole, not Jacksonville. But they've gotten a shit ton of snow. So I can't imagine they're open or passable or anything like that. So anyway, 7 Mile in the middle of February, that's not too bad. We've had a lot of warm weather the last couple weeks, so you know, this is significantly melted compared to how it was. Now you see that shelf. So anyway, I'm going to make it all the way back to the trailhead. And then I think I'm going to head back up and check out that Jeep. It seems kind of weird that it's just parked on the side of the road like that. I don't think there's anybody around, but just want to check it out. Be a good Samaritan. There's just so much power. I'm barely giving it throttle. That is crazy. And it just soaks up the bumps, man. This is a fantastic machine. So there you have it, 7 Mile in the middle of February, from the top near Swamp Creek all the way to the bottom, which is the trailhead. And there's the old truck. Alright, so anyway, this is the trailhead to 7 Mile. They got a nice parking area here, and then you head up Manhattan Road, County Road 69 up there. I don't know, about a half, 2 miles maybe. And then you hit the west end trailhead of Kelly Flats. So you can hit up three separate trails. Kelly Flats, 7 Mile, and then Swamp Creek. And if you're real ambitious, then you can load up and go up to Bald Mountain Trail 517. So you technically could get four, I guess five, then Bald Mountain connects with Killpacker and yada yada yada. So anyway, there's 7 Mile in the middle of February, and a 2017 Polaris RZR S 1000. Peace!